Hi there, in this new video about Microsoft Teams, I'm going to show you how you can create an organizational wide team in Microsoft Teams. For doing that, what I'm going to do is just click on Join or Create a Team, just the usual thing you have to do when creating a team from the Teams client. So click on Create a Team, and then on the Creation Team window, just specify the name for your global team. In this case, I'm going to name it Worldwide Team. Just add a description. And the key here is just to choose the organizational wide option in the privacy drop down. As you can see here, what we are going to do is just to create an organizational wide team, what means everyone in our organization is going to be automatically added to the team. You need to know also that there is currently a limitation in this kind of teams, and is in regards of the amount of teams members that is limited to 1,000. I think this is going to change in the future. So for now, this is something you have to be aware of. If you get this team, you are not going to have everybody added if you are part of an organization with more than 1,000 people. I don't know the criteria that the creation process follows in order to determine who is going to be part of the team and who is not going to be part of the team. So just click on Next, and the creation process for the team is happening. And what is happening behind the scenes is that everybody in our organization is automatically added to the team. Indeed, you have a message in the general channel that is just saying that. This user and 22 others are part of our team. Actually, this is the total number of users I have in my test tenant. And we can go over the manage options in the team, manage team. And as you can see here in the members, you have all the users that are part of my tenant. Yeah, you can see here that apparently the users that that have a kind of a administration role in the tenant are added as owners in the team, and the rest of the users are just member. Obviously, guest users shouldn't appear here in this shouldn't appear in this team, but you can find some weird issues when dealing with these kind of teams. Another thing is that you can create more than a global team, more than an organizational wide team in Microsoft Teams. As you can see here, I have indeed two global teams with all the people that is part of my Office 365 member as members of those teams. And that's all. I hope you have found this video useful. Yeah, see you soon. Bye bye.